A sports documentary written and directed by a Filipino-Canadian filmmaker tells the story of the abrupt exit of Vancouver's first and only NBA team, the Grizzlies. Israel Kando reports.
Filipino-Canadian filmmaker Kathleen Jaime was just 6 years old when she fell in love with basketball. Her dad used to take her to the neighborhood basketball court since she was three. But it was Vancouver's hometown team that sealed her lifelong love for the sport.
You know, the NBA came to town. My Lola, my dad would bring myself and my brother to many games, and I instantly fell in love with the game of basketball thanks to the Vancouver Grizzlies.
The Vancouver Grizzlies started playing for the NBA in 1995. For the 6 years that the team played in Vancouver, Kat's dad, JJ, also held 6 years' worth of season tickets.
The first time Vancouver had a professional sports team in that kind of level, the NBA. And so it was, it was exciting. We've never seen an NBA game live.
But luck wasn't on the side of the team, and the Grizzlies found themselves at the bottom of the heap year after year. Not once did they make it to the playoffs. The Grizzlies were eventually transferred to Memphis in the U.S., a development that surprised Kat.
Yeah, when they left, you know, I was heartbroken when the Grizzlies left town. I didn't think it was going to be forever. I thought I was only 12 years old when the Grizzlies left, and I didn't realize that when the NBA leaves a city, they don't come back. So that was really tough.
In 2016, she set out to uncover the truth behind the team's abrupt exit from Canada. Traveling all over North America in search of the people behind the team and the basketball pros who played in Vancouver. The Grizzly Truth is not Kat's first documentary about the team. She also made the critically acclaimed docu Finding Big Country in 2018 with the mission of finding her favorite player, Bryant Reeves, the Grizzlies' first ever NBA draft pick. After basketball, Kat's second love is filmmaking. She said it's in her blood, as her mother is related to Dr. Ciriaco Santiago of the famous Santiago filmmaking clan.
He owned one of the three major studios, Premier Productions. And then his son, Ciro Santiago, was a very influential director and producer. His younger brother is my Lola, Danilo Santiago. He was a director.
Kat said the Grizzly Truth pays tribute not just to the Grizzly fans in Vancouver, but also to all Filipinos who are known the world over for their love of basketball. The Grizzly Truth will be shown in theaters across Canada starting Friday, December 9th. Kat will be at a special pre-screening event at the Hot Docs Ted Rogers Cinema in Toronto on Saturday with the former NBA Rookie of the Year, Steve Francis, and former Raptor, Jimmy King. Israel Kando, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.
The European Commission proposing a new round of sanctions against Russia. The latest measures target nearly 200 more Russian individuals and entities, including the country's armed forces. The Commission also wants to cut Moscow's access to drones and unmanned aerial vehicles by banning the exports of drone engines to Russia. The sanctions still need to be approved by the European Parliament. These would be the European Union's ninth package of sanctions against Russia since the war in Ukraine began. The bloc has so far blacklisted over 1,000 individuals and more than 100 entities connected to Moscow.